As we have taken in first lecture, the topics which were covered in first lecture were introduction to OPAMP, history of OPAMP, and then what is the OPAMP parameters, and what was the OPAMP IC about. Now we will see applications. So there are several applications which we can list, but in my explanation topic, I am taking basic three, which will be easier for you to understand. Number one is A to D converters, okay, analog to digital converters. Number two is as a power source, it can also use as a current source. Number three means it can be used as a zero crossing detector, the application which generates the square wave from the sine wave. So the op-amp is the circuit which can generate the sine wave to square wave. So it is also known as a wave shaping circuit. It can change the input from sine wave to square wave. For example, if you are having any circuit at which you output, you require the digital pulse. So for that, you can apply the op-amp you can use, because op-amp can generate a perfect square wave at the output if any irregular shape waveform is given at the input. Okay. Once again, I am repeating this definition, which is very important. Op-amp is a circuit which can generate a perfect square wave at the output if an irregular shape waveform is given at the input. Now, moving towards next slide is A to D converter. From analog to digital converter and digital to analog converters, okay, they are very important blocks with the interface sensors. Okay, so this is generalized what I am saying, how it can be used. Okay, we are not going into the deep. So an ADC takes an analog signal and converts it into a binary one. Binary is nothing but a 1010, while DAC converts a binary signal into analog. Okay, so this figure shows, see, a human mic speaking on microphone which takes the input as a sound waves and performs a gives as an electrical signal to ADC. So ADC will convert that analog signal into digital. Again, it will be given to DAC and then to the speaker. So op-amp is an important circuit in both ADC and DAC. You can see the sine wave is this, and this is 1010 and final VDAC. Okay, so digital processing of the signal is very important, and this from op-amp is very helpful in this. Second is op-amp as a current source, means it can also be used as a current source. A current source can be made from inverting amplifier only, as shown in figure. The current in the load resistor R0 must be equal to the current in the R1. The current is then obtained by dividing the input voltage R1. Okay, so simple connection, you can use it as a current source. Number three is nothing but a zero crossing detector. Zero crossing detector means it will compare it with its graph from the zero, from plus VSET to minus VSET, maximum input voltage in positive direction, maximum input voltage in negative direction. It will compare it with the zero line in your graph, okay, and then it will if your input voltage in the sine wave is going from 0 volt to maximum volt, so it will convert it into plus VSET. And if your input voltage in sine wave is going from 0 volt to minus in the graph, so it will convert it into minus VSET. Means plus VSET is nothing but a maximum saturation, and minus VSET is nothing but a maximum saturation in minus direction. Okay, so this is your advantages, which we can see as a universal amplifier, voltage comparator. It can be also used in a precision rectifier, which we will take in next lecture. Analog to digital converters, digital to analog converters, filters, differentiators and integrators, voltage and current regulator, analog computers. Okay, so there are many advantages. Disadvantages means most op-amp are designed for lower power operation. We cannot use it in higher power operation. For higher output, op-amp specifically designed for the purpose which we use in low frequency. Okay, most commercial op-amp shuts off when the load resistance is below a specific level, means it can be used in specified bandwidth. Okay, so in this lecture we have studied the basic applications. There are more applications we will also take in next lecture. Okay, thank you.